Here are 10 new shortcuts inspired by you. Get the high temperature for today in a notification and set a reminder to close your windows. Better options for scanning a document with Toolbox Pro. Get summaries of your long emails, plus add any events to your calendar automatically. Organize your week's photos into albums and more. These come from my shortcuts community at create.beard.fm. Would love if you join there and in the comments below. So if you have shortcuts requests, leave them down there, and links to download all these are there as well. Frank from my community requested this. When you run this shortcut, it will find your calendar events in the next day. Then you can choose what events you want to set alarms for travel time. It's also going to get directions from your current location to that event and then set the alarm accordingly. Now, the shortcut link I'll put below will check the next 16 hours, so basically for the next workday if you run this at night, but I changed it so I can pull some events from this past weekend. You'll get a menu of events. Choose which events you'd like to create those travel alerts for. When you pick an event, make sure to hit Always Allow. Choose the location that's being pulled from that event information. And now you have an alarm created for when you need to leave. If we go over to the clock app, it'll create two alarms. One alarm is called Work Soon, which goes off 75 minutes before that event starts. And the next one includes the travel time to that event, so you know you need to leave for work. If you travel a lot for work and alarms letting you know when to leave will be helpful, this is a shortcut for you. All right, this next one was super fun to build. This was from Key in the Shortcuts community, but they're a football fan and wanted to know the schedules of games for several teams. Now these teams, namely the Cleveland Browns, Jaguars, and Panthers, have a page on their website that shows the next available game, but it's not really formatted easily to be able to parse the text. So this shortcut actually gets the HTML from that page, uses ChatGPT to parse the information, and then shows me in Quick Look when the next games are for these teams. So if I run this shortcut, now I can see the next game schedules for each of those teams right here. If you want to get fancy, you could even add these to your calendar, but let me know if you want something like that down in the comments. This next one was requested by Button in the community. They wanted to be able to manually crop a screenshot and even sharing it without having to save it to your camera roll. This is another Toolbox Pro action, which is really powerful. Now you can program this to the action button or the back tap, so you can do this on any screen. But when the shortcut runs, it takes a screenshot, click Always Allow, then you can manually crop it. You can change the format here, like original or maybe square. This is actually being done in Toolbox Pro. And then when you tap Done, it'll go back to the shortcut to finish running and then open the share sheet, and you can save the image, immediately share it without having to save it to your camera roll, and more. I'll save it just so we can take a look. And there we see the crop screenshot right there. That's now also saved to my photos. Next, Kristen in the YouTube comments asked for a reminder to close their windows if the temperature is going to be high for that day. So what I've done is you can make this an automation to run like every morning, and it's gonna check what the high temperature is for today. And if the high temperature is 80 degrees or over, you're gonna get a notification that also creates an alarm to let you know to close the windows about 1 p.m., right before the hottest time of day. If the high temperature is below 80 degrees, you'll see this notification and it'll say it didn't create an alarm for that day. If we run it, you'll see the notification pop up here and you'll say the high will be 84 today. I've created an alarm to close the windows. Let's go to the clock app and see what it did. And there's our close windows alarm for 1 p.m. Now, if you have some smart home devices like in HomeKit, maybe an Eve Weather measuring the temperature outside, you can create an automation in the Home app. So here in Home, I'm gonna go to Automation, tap the plus icon, and we're gonna do Add Automation. Here, we're gonna choose a sensor detects something, and you'll see here in my backyard, I have an Eve temperature. It's actually part of the Eve Weather. Then you can specify if the temperature rises above 79 degrees. So once it hits 80 degrees or higher, you can also choose to run this automation only during the day, only when specific people are home, and however you want to customize it. Tap Next, and then we're going to scroll all the way to the bottom and convert this to a shortcut. Now, if you want to control your smart home and maybe blink a light red because the temperature is hot, you can do that. But unfortunately, Show Notification is not a shortcuts action here because it's a HomeKit automation. So what you can do is use the Get Contents from URL action, and here you can paste a pushcuts URL. I've talked about pushcuts in previous videos, but it's a great app, free to use to set up three automations. So you can set up three notifications like this completely for free. If you want more, then you do need to pay. But here in pushcuts, you can just tap the plus icon, name this notification. I'm gonna call this the high temp notification, and the text in the notification will say close the windows. I'll tap add. Then all you have to do is copy the URL down here at the bottom, copy URL. We'll hit done here in pushcuts, go back over to this shortcut, and then paste the URL in this action. Now when the temperature rises above 79 degrees, we're gonna get a notification. We can test this by hitting the play icon down here, and we should get that pushcuts notification here on my phone. If I swipe my lock screen down, you'll see that notification. I'm in a focus mode, so it didn't pop through immediately. But typically you would normally see that from push cuts, high temp, close the windows. Now you'll get that notification whenever it rises above 80 degrees outside. Now, if you don't have an Apple Smart Home yet, I actually have an entire video walking through that setup process step-by-step from getting your first HomePod mini to adding your first HomeKit device. You can watch that video right up here, and I'll link it down in the description as well. Next, James on YouTube wanted to be able to scan a document and then save it to a specific folder on his iPhone. Now, there is a scan document action built into Shortcuts, but it's pretty limited. Using the scan document action, you can't choose where it gets saved, and you just get kicked over to the Files app. So instead, I would recommend using Toolbox Pro. That's an app that adds lots of Shortcuts actions to your iPhone. I'll link the app down in the description. But using the Toolbox Pro action, you'll go to the scanning mechanism, take as many pages as you would like. You need this wait to return action, and you can just download the shortcut via the link below. Then you're going to make a PDF from clipboard, because what it does is adds those images to your clipboard. And then you can choose to save that PDF, and this Files action asks where you want to save it. So if we were to run this shortcut, you're gonna go over to the Toolbox Pro app, but actually it just shows the document scanner. We'll scan a document here. Then when you tap Save, you'll go over to Shortcuts, and it will ask you where you want to save this PDF. You can choose your desktop or another folder. We'll just choose our desktop here, tap Open, and now that PDF is saved. If we go over to our Files app, we'll see the PDF right here. Next, Frank from the community wanted a shortcut where when they get an email, he can get a summary of the whole email, plus add any dates to his calendar. So I have a shortcut here that uses ChatGPT multiple times. You will need the ChatGPT installed on your phone. It can be a little buggy. Open the app before running the shortcut. But once you have the shortcut downloaded, now whenever you have an email, we're gonna make it a PDF first. You do that by hitting the reply icon, and then let's go down to print. This way, if it's a very long email that doesn't fit on one screen, the take screenshot action wouldn't capture it all. So PDF, you know you'll get all the information. Now we're gonna tap the share button here, scroll down, and we're gonna run the event and summary email GPT. It's gonna get the text from that PDF, send it to ChatGPT with a couple custom prompts, and then show us any dates that it may have found and add it to our calendar. Now it found all the pertinent information, including the date, the time, the place, and it's added a summary of the email to the notes section of that event. Now I can just add it to my calendar and I'm good to go. Another request from the community was to automate private relay when they open a certain app, because private relay is just not compatible since it's like a VPN. Now you can't turn private relay on or off directly, but using this custom URL scheme, you can jump right to the private relay setting. So when I hit play, you'll get jumped directly to this screen where you can toggle private relay on or off. Then if you want to make it automated, go to the automation tab, tap the plus icon, and then go down to app. Then when app is opened, and you can choose multiple apps from this list if you wanted to. And you can say, when app is opened, run immediately, don't notify when run. Now, I don't typically use this, but I'm gonna say run after confirmation, because even after you adjust private relay, you're gonna have to open that app back up, and this automation is gonna wanna run. So I'm gonna choose run after confirmation so we don't get kicked out automatically every time. Now we're gonna search for our private relay settings shortcut, which you could download below in the description. Now, whenever I open the 1Password app, that automation is gonna run in the background, and I can choose if I want to tap it, I can choose run, then I'll be here at the private relay setting and I can toggle it on or off. But the next time I open it and the shortcut wants to run, I'll just swipe it away so I don't get kicked out when I'm trying to use the app. And remember, if you have a shortcuts request that you'd love me to prioritize in a video, then join my community at create.beard.fm. Over 1500 people there who have joined for free. You can interact with other members. And if you've created a shortcut you're really proud of, share it with everyone. But you can support the community with $5 a month and join over 360 people who do that. You get my shortcut of the week, which I don't feature in any videos, like my Apple Newsroom summarizer, logging health samples, and even creating your own YouTube subscription feed in Shortcuts. Plus you get access to my custom Shortcuts GPT, which is great for using APIs and really honing that match text to action, which is very powerful in Shortcuts. I'll talk about that in a video soon. And you can drop your Shortcuts request in this space, which I respond to every single post. And that's if you support the membership community at create.beard.fm. All right, this next shortcut was requested by Tony in the community, and they wanted to be able to organize their photos every week into some specific albums. Namely, he has albums called Work, Personal, Wallpaper, and what I've done here is it will find all the photos in the last week, go photo by photo, and then allow you to move it to the specific album that you want. This way, every week, all your photos are organized, but keep in mind these albums do need to be created, or you can change the album names using the text fields here at the top. So instead of funny or inspiration, you can use your own. And this action will also only pull photos that are not already in an album. So you're only organizing photos that need to go somewhere. Remember, you need all these albums in order for the shortcut to work, or you can just minus these and add the ones that pertain to your photo library. Next, Joe wanted to be able to dictate a message and then choose who to send it to. But typically when choosing contacts, you either have too many or you don't want to have to type someone's name. So what I've done here is created a shortcut where you can dictate a text, and that's going to show you all the contacts in a group that you have selected. I will create a contact list and then add the few contacts you text often there. This way they pop up in the menu, and then it's going to send that dictated text to the contact that you choose. So if I run this, maybe I'll say, hey, it was great seeing you today. Would love to schedule a lunch for a couple weeks. Then I'm going to be able to choose contacts from that contact list. I'll choose a person, and then it'll show me the text message compose window, has the dictated text to the person I chose, and I'm ready to send. Next, if you have a lot of receipts and you're trying to keep track of it for expenses, you can do it a couple ways. Lee wanted to save it to a specific album and photos, and you can do that with a simple two-step action. Take a photo, that's a shortcuts action, and then save it, and then choose the photo album of your choice here. That'll just save photos of your receipt to that photo album. But if you want to make each photo a PDF and then save it to a certain folder, you can do that too. I'll X out that second action, find the Make PDF action here, and we'll make PDF from photos. You can also change this to ask each time. So maybe you have like three receipts. Well, now I can say three photos, and then it will make a PDF from all those photos, and then we'll add the Save Files action. I'll have this ask where to save, or if you just want to choose a specific folder, this way it saves it to your expenses folder every time. Let's actually create a new folder. We'll call it expenses, tap open, and now it'll save it automatically there. Now when I run this shortcut, it's going to ask how many photos I want to take. Let's choose two. It'll open the back camera. I'll just take one photo for now, put it in the frame, take the picture, when I tap Use Photo, it's going to automatically make that into a PDF and save it to that specific folder. Now, if we go to the Expenses folder and Files, there's a PDF of the image I had there. One other pro tip, if you want to be able to rename that file, this way it's not just random numbers and letters, you can search for the Rename action, and we'll choose Ask Each Time. This way it'll ask you the file name every time you take the photo. I'll put a link to this version of the shortcut down below. And those are 10 shortcuts you requested. Let me know which other requests you have, either down in the comments of this video, or again, join my community at create.beard.fm. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button, and I'm approaching 50 videos in my shortcuts playlist. So if you want to go back and just binge them all, lots of ideas there with requests from you. I'll put that playlist right up here, and YouTube thinks you'll really like this video. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.